So you want to use the arranger track in Cubase? Awesome. So these are the building blocks of a song, from having just the intro to the full chorus and everything in between, like verse A, verse B, a bridge. You get the idea. So now you want to turn these blocks of music into an arrangement. Maybe you're in a songwriting session, or you're making an extended version of a song, or a shorter version of it. You can think of a lot of situations where you don't want to be like this. Like maybe this needs to be twice as long, so cut these, scoot these over here, and then duplicate this. That's a lot of fiddling. So to make that whole process easier, you can do it like this. Right click, create an arranger track, and with the pencil tool, draw your different sections in here. Or you can set your cycle region and double click. Or if you have cycle markers set up, you can learn how to do that in this video. Double click those and then double click in the arranger track. And just like any event, you can change the color over here. A little side note, I have my preferences set so that my events don't display a name, but this also affects the arranger events, and here you definitely want to see the names. So if that's the case for you as well, go to Preferences, Event Display, Show Event Names. To then change the names, you can select one and go here. Or go here, Alt or Option, double click. If you would need it, you can also have events overlap like this. Now it's time to make an arrangement. Here you can see Arranger Chain 1, and if I double click one of these or drag it, it's gonna go in that chain. Let's have verse A twice, and then I want it to go straight to the chorus. So intro one time, verse two times, and the chorus. When the arranger track is activated, you can see that here, and I hit play, it's gonna play this entire chain I just made. If you don't wanna click or drag the event blocks, you can go in here and click or drag these. You can also rearrange them, type the repeat number, instead of adding the same one multiple times. Or you can click this E and do everything in here. Again, by dragging or double clicking. Here you get time information for every step, but also the total time. This is very useful. For example, when I'm making the music bed for these tutorials, let's say the video is 4 minutes, then I can look at this last one and make sure it's at least 4 minutes. This dialogue also gives you a different visual of the repeats. So the arrows indicate the event that's playing or will be playing, and the little blocks show you which repeat you're on. You can even click one to start the chain there. But if you want to try out a completely different arrangement, you can create a new chain by clicking this plus, or by duplicating the one that's active here. You can also delete one, and you can rename them by clicking this button. In the inspector, you can find all of these functions in this drop-down menu. We haven't talked about the modes yet, so if you click on these hyphens, you can choose to have an event repeat forever, or pause after repeats, which basically means the chain stops playing until you hit play again, and then it continues where it stopped. And in the dialog, that's over here. With these arrows, you control the chain steps, and these control the repeats within a chain step. Also good to know, if you want to preview events, it's going to follow the jump mode just like it would when you're playing a chain. The jump mode options are here. You would usually have it jump to the next event at the end of the one that's playing, but you have all these options. And then there's one last section over here, flatten chain. If you flatten a chain, you consolidate your arrangement as it is in the chain. And of course, this comes with a bunch of options. Which chain do you want to flatten? One or multiple? You probably want to do it in a new project. Like Aristotle said, save as to save your ass. These are naming options for the new project, and here you can choose to keep the arranger track. For these two, I'll add a MIDI event so I can easily show you. You can make real event copies. By default, it's going to make shared copies. And you can have it split or not split the events. So we'll leave those as they are. I want to open the new project immediately. And cascading will just kind of shift the project window. I don't need that. So let's make a MIDI event with notes inside of the chorus section. One that starts before it and ends after. And then one that starts before it and one that ends after. Just so we can see how it splits. So click flatten chain, I'm gonna activate, and this is our chain laid out in a project. Let's take a look at those MIDI events in the chorus. We chose to make shared copies, so if I delete a note in this one, it's also gone over here. The splitting, honestly, I'm not sure because I flattened it twice. This one is split and this one is don't split. And they treated the notes the exact same way. And this is what the manual says. So either my brain is not braining or this function is not functioning. Feel free to let me know which one it is. And then one more thing, you can also use a MIDI controller to trigger the arranger events. This could be for live performances or just to try out different arrangements. If you don't know how, I'll show you how I did it really quickly because this could be a whole separate tutorial. Go into MIDI remote in the lower zone, add surface, fill this in, select your device here, create. You can choose a pad here. MIDI learn is on. I don't have a controller with pads, so I press my first key on the MIDI keyboard. And if I click this, you can see it's assigned correctly. Repeat this for every key I want to use. I'm going to leave a little gap here so it matches the layout of my keyboard. Then go to the mapping assistant. Press that key again and look for trigger arranger event 1. Apply mapping. And then complete that for the rest of your keys or pads. Let's set the jump mode to 2 bars, just for this example, so we don't have to wait too long between jumps. Now I'm triggering my intro and then setting up the chorus to go next. You can tell by this orange arrow. Then verse A. And I'm gonna let that one repeat itself, which it does by default. My light broke down, but I hope this helped. If it did, please like the video and also subscribe and have fun making music.